This is May. I'm back, and this time I want to show you how to color some eyes. I'll be color the eye in this Jasmine Becket-Griffith Halloween book. Jasmine is one of my favorite artists. I just love her. And her girls has a lot of nice faces, usually very large faces too, and big eyes. And these big eyes and large faces are awesome to color and to have fun with. So this is the type of eye I want to show you how I'm doing. We'll be working with the Prismacolor pencils. For the eyes, I'm gonna use this Cobalt Blue U PC133, and we wanna have non-photo blue PC, I don't know, I can't tell any longer which number that one is, but it's the non-photo blue. And this is a light aqua PC992. And we have Springarin PC913, and we have a yellow, which is lemon yellow, PC915, lemon yellow, and then we have one of my baby whites, PC938. I do have new white and pencils, but this baby works for now. So I'm starting with making a line in the inner circle with the darkest blue, and I'm making another line just around the outer circle, which is like where the eye starts. If you look at an eye, it usually have this darker ring around it. Then I'm making lines, some long lines, some shorter, some long, short, long, short, a little longer, and just keep doing that. Now in this area it will be kind of fuzzy, so I'll just color a little bit with this, just putting down a little thin layer. Then I will make the same lines from the inner part of the eye, trying to make some longer and some shorter ones. Changing color to the middle blue, which is the non-photo blue. Doing the same thing, just making some lines here and there. And same in the inner circle, changing again to the light aqua, which is a green bluish color. Just coloring some lines. Then we'll take the green and adding some green specks in. You don't need that many of this, and then a yellow one just for some. I'll take one and one maybe here. Well, let's take one up there. Now I try not to take the yellow next to the green, because then it won't show and everything will just look green. But it can be a bit hard to do that. Then I'm just doing the line once more, just to darken it up a little bit. And now I'll make some specks in this upper part too. So then we are gonna do the magic. This is a part where you blend everything in. You're just kind of smushing it down. And yes, smushing is a technical term for this. Just smushing colors together like this around the whole eye. Now the Prismacolor colors are so soft, so they blend so easily and almost by themselves. There you are. Now if I want to, I can go in and add some greens like here and there where I feel I lost some parts of it, and just adding a little more yellow like that, and then I'll take my darkest one again and go around the edge a little bit just to darken everything up a little bit. So when you are coloring eyes, you can do this with any colored eyes. Just put in some colors and mush it in, and just see how it goes. And usually it's working. Like in green eyes, you can add almost any colors. You can add blue, aqua, yellow, some orange, brown maybe. The next is to do the eyeball. Now, in young people's eyes, the eyeball is never white, eyeball never is fully white. In younger people's, their eyeballs are more light blue, and in older people's eyes there, they actually are more yellowish. Then I'm sorry, I forgot to tell you this color. This is Cloud Blue, PC 1023. And for my shadings I'm using indigo blue, PC901. That I'm just adding around the edge here. And I'm going back again with the cloud blue and just kind of pulling it down a little bit. And on the other side. I think it needs to be a little bit more or a little bit darker. So I am pulling it a little bit down. I'm sorry, I got to turn the book just some so I can get this circle nice. Now, usually when I color, I'm turning my book or my page around and then upside down and whatever way that I need to, actually. I'm just blending this out a little bit more, taking it down like this. And I think I want a little bit shadow under the eyelid too. Not much, just a little bit. Then I'm blending that back in too. So there we are. Then we actually have this little, let me just change the pencils, this little area in there. To color that, I'm using mahogany red, PC1029, and I'm using peach, PC939. Then I'm just putting the darkest color, the mahogany, further in, and the peach a little bit more out, and blending those two colors together. I need a little bit more of the stark red. So, like that, I think. I also like to use a white gel pen. This is my Sakura gel roll, just to remove this white line in the eyes a little bit, because it's usually no lines inside an eye. And then I'm putting just a little bit highlight in there too. Just stepping it down so it's not a big blob. Then I can add some highlight in there. Now this girl's eyes can have any highlights. Many like to make this big oval bow over the eye. I don't like that. Or you can make a kind of star looking highlight too. But now I also see that my shadow has to come a little bit further down into this pink area. There, I think we are almost as good as done. Now I do want to soften this blue out a little bit and just blend it just some. So I'm taking my white and I'm doing that. Just like that. And I'll also take my white over this black line here. I can use my gel pen and cover it fully, but that's no. Or that's not necessary. So I'm just doing it like that. So this is how I color eyes. So I hope you enjoyed this and that is helpful, and I'll see you all soon.